Hello, everybody, and welcome to another episode of Game Plan Review. This, of course, is fourth of my five gameplay reviews for my birthday special. And today I'm going to do a Game Boy Color game. And this is actually a SpongeBob SquarePants game, which I've never played. I never played any of the SpongeBob SquarePants games. I figured I'd give this game a try. I actually picked it up at the local game store that will be going out of business in February, I think February 8th. And the game is called SpongeBob SquarePants, of course, and it is Legend of the Lost Spatula. Now, this is one of the SpongeBob SquarePants games that I've seen. Unfortunately, this was the only one I could pick up, because the remainder of the SpongeBob SquarePants games, they were not available anymore. They had shipped them out to the place that they're still being in business in, while I had to settle for this one. Hopefully I will get more SpongeBob SquarePants games in the near future. I'll have to probably get them online or at a pawn shop. But eventually I'm going to try this one. And it will be today. That is right. I am going to play this game and review it. And the only way I'm going to find out if it's either one of the classics or a terrible game is if I actually pop this game in and play it. So here I go, and here's my gameplay review of SpongeBob SquarePants Legend of the Lost Spatula. All right. I'm going to start the game up. Good news is I have the Game Boy Player. So I can play any game that I want to play. Come here. First ever SpongeBob SquarePants game I've ever played. About SquarePants. Gonna start the game. Okay, you got to continue on. And yep, that's not a bad password system. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, 10. Gotta fill out and get some numbers and a dash. Okay. Options. Okay, so you can turn the music on. You can turn the sound effects on. Welcome, my friends, to Bikini Bottom. Let us join SpongeBob. Okay. Look out, SpongeBob! What is this? He has uncovered something. So it looks like there's a narrator. Or maybe it's his brain, I don't know. Wow, Mr. Krabs will know what this is. Mr. Krabs, I found a statue. My great Neptune's beard. statue marks the entrance to the Duchessman's underworld. A long time ago in the city of Palm Bay, there was the master fry cook who ruled with the golden spatula. But Mr. Krabalos, I can't pronounce that, Mount Krabalosius, buried Palm Bay, starting the grease fires that ended the greasy civilization. As legend has it, the Flying Dutchman took over the city's ruins, and his first mates buried the key to the city somewhere in the Goo Lagoon. Find that key, boy. If you get the golden spatula, I'll be rich. I would be master fry cook. Oh, you would be master fry cook, excuse me. Now you better go home and get your things. Press the A button to use item or accept. Press the B button to jump or go back. Press up to talk to your friends. It jumps very high. What's the start button here? Resume game, start area, quit game. Oh, you get a password right away. That's cool. So that's a good sign right there. You get a password right away once you pause the game. That's the first time I've ever seen that before. I will say that, where you get a password when you pause the game. I don't think that's ever happened in a video game. If there's any other game that has that, let me know. So you get hit two times and you're dead. Meow. Oh, it's you. No shit, Sherlock.
Duh.
That's what he says. SpongeBob jumped very high. Okay. Okay. All right. So far, I don't like the controls. He's slippery when you jump. Press the button. It's so slippery. I wonder if blowing bubbles is anything. Yeah. Oh, wait a minute, I'm gonna back. That's what. Wait a minute, so. Oh. So far the controls suck. I'm having a hard time at times when I jump, when I want to move. It's slippery. And I can tell you only get two hits before you die, like... You guessed it. You. Looks like there's no lives, so you got unlimited lives. I was surprised that he's naked when you lose your pants and then you get hit. Yeah, that's if I want it. I wish the controls were better. So you just get a fresh pair of pants and that's it. Yeah, that's where I want to go. To the Goo Lagoon. Thank you. Why is it not letting me? There we go. It was sticky. Okay, so I have to press A. Careful, the goo is sticky. Man. That's pretty funny. Music's not bad. I'll be quite honest with you. The music isn't too bad. It could be a lot better though. Wait a minute. That was pretty funny. Net launcher. So how to use it, that's the question. Okay, so that must be the select button. Okay. Find the anchor, recover the chest. Okay. So that's the net launcher. What's this? Oh, I didn't know that. So I could have gone jellyfishing. Oh, well. Okay, so you do get ammo. So at least the weapons are not useless, thank God. That's another reason why I don't like the controls. What? Okay. So I think kind of... he likes to dance every single time that I keep him still. That's my biggest gripe with the game so far, is the controls. Okay, that's what I was supposed to do. Okay. At least it tells you that's a good sign. So far, the controls is the only thing I don't like about this game. That would have helped with the platforming if the controls were a little better. There are four oven knobs needed to unlock the statue. They are hidden around Bikini Bottom. Here's the map. Okay. Look out, Flying Dutchman, here comes SpongeBob. This is a hard game, y'all. Oh, it worked. Holy moly, it worked. Good. Get. At least it gives you health power ups. That's a good thing. So you're not totally useless. So far the game isn't bad, but it could be a lot better. At least you don't lose lives and have to start all over again. That's a good thing. So there's a couple of positives that I can give to this game. I will say it's challenging, and that's good. Good. See, I just suck at this game. I wish the weapon selection could have been better. Not terrible. Isn't that bad, but duck. Or not. See, that's my problem. This is challenging. I think I'm gonna stop there. I think I've played enough to make my decision. All right, my review of SpongeBob SquarePants, Legend of the Lost Spatula. I'm gonna start with the green card positives. I thought that having unlimited lives was a really good idea. I did like that. The graphics weren't too bad. I thought the graphics were quite good. I don't think the music was too bad either, the tracks that I heard. And it looks like that it does have some other redeemable qualities as well. And I will say this, the gameplay isn't bad either. There are some things, however, that bring this game down a little bit. And I think the biggest problem that I had with this game is with the controls. And that's the red card part. The problem that I had was that the controls, when he jumps, when SpongeBob jumps, it seems like that he's slippery, and too slippery unless he's on the ground. It's not too bad when he's on the ground, but when he's jumping, you have to do certain jump to certain platforms, that becomes a problem. And another flaw that I had with this is only two hits, some of the ghosts and goblins. However, you do get some health power-ups, which is a good thing. So, that's more of a nitpick. So, I can consider that a yellow card flaw when it comes to the hits that you can take. That's yellow card. But the red card is with the controls. The controls could have been a lot better. And that's what brings the gameplay down slightly. And as a result, my decision for this particular game, and that's really the only biggest problem that I had, was with the controls. I think if was it for the controls, I think I could have considered this a fantastic game. So here is my yellow, green, or red card decision. I am giving SpongeBob SquarePants, Legend of the Lost Spatula, a yellow card. I don't think I can quite recommend this, but it's not too bad. That's the reason why I'm giving it a yellow card. You might like it, you might not. I thought it was only okay, and it could have been a lot better if it wasn't for the controls. The controls bring the gameplay down slightly, and I think as a result, I didn't enjoy this game as much as I thought I would have. So as a result, a yellow card. But that don't mean that it's terrible. And it's not a bad game at all. I just think that the controls bring the game slightly down. But there are some good aspects that keep it from being a terrible or even a bad game for that matter. But the controls, if they would have been a lot better in my opinion, and not slippery when he jumps and moves around the platform. To go from platform to platform, I probably would have given this a green card. I would have given this a green card. I really would have. But the controls, however, take any chance of this being a green card away. So as a result, I had to give it a yellow card. I had no choice. But I'm still keeping this thing. I'm still keeping it because it's a part of my collection. And hopefully I'll find another SpongeBob SquarePants game that might actually be better than this. So for the first SpongeBob SquarePants game that I ever reviewed and ever played, yellow card. However, there might actually be some SpongeBob SquarePants games that are awesome. If you know of any, let me know. Comment down below. And let me know which SpongeBob SquarePants games are actually awesome. And point out the bad games as well. Point out the bad SpongeBob SquarePants games as well. But like I said, yellow card for this. And that's my review of SpongeBob SquarePants, Legend of the Lost Spatula. And I'm sorry that I don't sound it myself. I've been dealing with a cold lately. So as a result, that's why I sound like that. I do apologize. But that's my review of SpongeBob SquarePants, Legend of the Lost Spatula, like I mentioned. So, thank you very much for watching. And the last episode of gameplay and review for my birthday special will be tomorrow. Alright? I hope you enjoyed, and I will catch you next time. Peace out. Happy gaming. And by the way, there will be a special game that I will be playing for the Dreamcast tomorrow. Check that out. Happy gaming, everybody. Later.